Hello, my name is Maria. My family and I immigrated into America, illegally from Mexico. I am a transgendered, 16 years old, and a Muslim. Praise Allah. Oh, and a feminist. And today, I managed to not only get into the YouTuber known as Tikibomber's account, I have already changed the password and email address. I did all of this to send a message to everyone else out there. I hate Tikibomber. I hate all the trolls she hangs out with while online too, but I will let my brothers and sisters deal with them. Sargon's hack is only the start. I hate Tikibomber because of many things. She stands against everything I represent. She likes to represent a huge number of people and ideas, even going as far as to say she will give away feminist pass to the trolls she talks to. There is no such thing as a feminist pass. Tikibomber is in no way a feminist. She tells everyone who is and who is not a feminist. I understand that truth is a thing. However, she's not even that. Her words are men, cis men mostly, and trans men after surgery cannot be feminists. They gain nothing within the movement outside of being an internal whipping boy for all the feminist women who dislike, distrust, and blame men for everything. They are better off being involved in the men's rights movement and becoming a men's rights advocate. More so if they join the feminist movement to try and gain sympathy and support for men's issues. Men are the reason why women suffer for so long under their oppressive thumbs. There is nothing wrong with men wanting to do the right thing and supporting feminism, as long as they remember that women will always have the right to speak up about our ideals, while they tell trolls and anti-feminists like Tikibomber that they should go and kill themselves, or they should get some high-costing, incurable disease. I am against harassment and bullying online, but I will be one to tell others to go die for disagreeing with me. Why can't Tikibomber and other women online who stand against feminism see that we care about them and want them to listen to us? To let us represent them online and let those women go back to whatever they were doing. Tikibomber also claims to be a video gamer. The only earliest things I could find of her playing a game was for Smite, and way before they changed out one of the characters. Those videos, however, were taken down for unknown reasons, and I've messaged her and asking why. She hasn't responded to me why she removed such early video game footage, which makes me think they're not hers to begin with. I know she has expressed how much she dislikes Anita Sarkeesian in the past, and continues to hold that hatred for a fellow video gamer, another gamer girl, no less. I wonder if she has a natural hatred for all these women who also play in games as well. Maybe she wants to be the only gamer girl in the entire world. I will admit that I've never played video games. They don't interest me at all with the graphic visuals of what I would assume to be shooting someone in the head and watching it explode all over. I don't see the hype of it, but still wish that women in video games and developing video games would let feminists like Zoe Quinn, Brianna Wu, and Anita Sarkeesian to continue to be their voice of concern in video games. I also think Tikibomber calls herself that online because she was originally going to use it for video game content, to record herself playing and giving reactions to video games like other video game players, like the racist, sexist, Islamophobic gamer called PewDiePie. She possibly selected the online name, not realizing both how cultural appropriating and triggering it would be. The first part of her online identity is Tiki, which is in reference to the Pacific Islands and the people who live there. To further prove this, she even has a poorly drawn image of a tiki mask to give a non-copywritten face with what she has to say. She's white, not a Pacific Islander,
Having done so many videos on her phone alone shows that she is even lit. She really needs to drop both the Tiki pedophile name and the mask icon from her identity and apologize to all the Pacific Islanders for such a horrible representation of their culture. No Pacific Islander, more so the women of the Pacific Islands, would ever approve of such a negative representation. The other part of her name is Burma, and could be connected to her history with the military. She claims it's a Grenada, but the Air Force and Navy both have weapons that can launch bombs as well, not just the Army. With that to keep in mind, bombers also destroy and blow up things. Combining her online identity together paints a huge racist picture she has to the Pacific Islanders. She wants to destroy them, and I feel that I'm the only one who caught on to this while researching about Tikibomber before hijacking her YouTube account. Anyone who wants to see a group of minorities killed off is clearly a dangerous racist, and we should look into exposing her address so she can get assaulted by Pacific Islanders. I feel really happy right now, hacking this very clearly anti-feminist, racist human garbage. She also stands against Sharia law, the law of the Islamic States, and the most feminist law to follow. Women want to be protected, and Sharia law does that. It protects women from being raped as long as they wear hijab. It protects women as long as they are obedient to their husbands, fathers, and brothers. It protects women as long as they don't leave the house alone. Sharia law protects women from all the dangers that feminism is fighting against with these men and shackle the two genders together. We are protected by Allah and Muhammad's teachings as long as we follow Sharia law. Those who don't clearly get punished. Being a Muslim, I can verify that Islam is very much a progressive religion. You don't have to actually be a Muslim to live in an Islamic state. Just follow Sharia law and you're protected. Why would so many women want to stand against something that protects them from rape, male gaze, catcalling, and throat rape? I don't understand that, and people like Tikibomber paint an out-of-control picture on this method, claiming that Sharia law removes free will, is a brutal law, and should never be accepted into Western society. I don't see any of that with Sharia law. Everyone loves one another in the Islamic States. We don't have violent protests. We don't have murders or rapes happening in the Islamic States. So why is she, and so many others against Sharia law? It's baffling. If you call yourself a feminist, then you clearly support Sharia law because of how protective the Islamic States are with the women. I really shouldn't complain too much about her argument against Sharia law. She prefers to sexualize women all over, and does a very bad job at that too. Trying to use a cleavage video to not only gain more subs, but also show more collarbone than cleavage in a thank you video she's done for the very few people she has on this channel. Though the number of people who are actually subscribed to her, it's the few people I'm reaching out to in hopes to stop all your horrible trolling memes, and for the men that watch her content to stop with your sexist behaviors, to stop sexualizing women as nothing more than objects to overlap and use for sex whenever you want. We are not sexual objects of desire. We are humans, and deserve to be protected by your harmful words left in comment sections on YouTube, harmful opinions on Twitter, and hate speech at college campuses across the nation. The few of you who flock to this channel for a chance to see actual boob needs to stop. Since Tikibomber clearly cannot stop herself from becoming a sexual object for male gaze gratification, I got lucky into hijacking this channel before she showed her pussy when she reached 1,000 subs here and 1,000 followers on her Twitter account. While on the topic of women bodies all over, she claims to be against women who are overweight when she's fat-faced herself. How can you hate people, mostly women, who are overweight when you're that very thing? I don't see you losing weight either, rather gaining more over the last 2 years, and you have no children for you to gain weight off from. Or so we're told you have no children. She's fat herself and tells overweight people that they need to lose weight. She really has no right to speak when she cannot do the very thing she promotes to others. I have been very happy to expose her for being an anti-woman, racist, and Islamophobic with her videos preaching about how people need to lose weight to live longer means she is not shy from body shaming. I really wish she sent in a full body photo to an Islam so he could give her a -4 on his body positive videos. She has also shown very aggressive hatred to the Hurt Progress group on Twitter and Facebook. The hashtag Hurt Progress are people who prefer their sexual partners to be children and wish to drop the age of consent. Then another thing I don't see in being a bad idea. Places like Japan has no age limit to the age of consent, so why should other Western worlds demonize children in adult relationships? Children are capable of consenting at the age of 6. They can tell you what they want and don't want for dinner at that age. So why would consenting at 6 be a bad thing? Children get married that young all over the world, and trying to protect those children as if they are pearls inside of a clam is never going to give them real-world experience. The things she says about the pedosexuals are following from her Twitter. Pedosexual is a pedophile. Get out of the LGBT and stay out. You are not welcome to add your sexuality into something that is usually criminalized because of your sexual choices and child molesters. Pedophiles and child molesters are practically the same thing. If you have a desire to have sex with children, then seek help right now. She has also posted some very harmful and hateful images under the hashtag HurtProgress of an image showing a row of bullets with the caption on the image, "Best cure for child molesters, just one shot needed." I'm surprised that she's gotten away with so much hatred being posted in both YouTube and Twitter. I'm more surprised that no one has even tried to argue against her points, as she's very much against the entire world. In my opinion of watching her rage-filled videos, the aggression she shows to each group so far is full of much malice. I believe that she is far worse than other YouTubers like Undyne, Baron, Sargon the Cloud, and Blair Red as an example. Tikibomber is an out-of-control forest fire and will continue to burn everything that's progressive until there's nothing left to burn. Apparently, I'm not alone in this. On a long-forgotten website called Fanfiction, there is another person who has clear contact with Tikibomber. Apparently, Tikibomber only made her own account to troll the other person with the site's terms of service and community guidelines. Calling her a dumb hoe and claiming that the harassment the other person is receiving from Tikibomber herself is nothing more than psychological warfare. Harassment is not psychological warfare, it's hate speech and against the law. Even if this person is breaking the terms of service on fanfiction, she isn't sitting there telling people to attack everyone else listed on her list of people to get permanently banned. Tikibomber painted a target sign on this particular person by taking her entire bio page out of context because they accused her for bashing on hashtag Black Lives Matter while saying that Tikibomber is also an uneducated social justice warrior. Tikibomber went even further by not giving a link to where the message itself came from, and I only came across the page because of Google searching on YouTube for everything related to Tikibomber herself. What's more disgusting is Tikibomber has threatened this person to publish her information. I'm not going to provide a name because this one individual has clearly suffered more than enough under the aggressive individual known as Tikibomber, and I think she deserves a break from any more abuse. To all my brothers and sisters who watched this video, please keep working to shut down these trolls as a whole. Change their accounts, emails, then passwords, so the owners can never get them back. We need to stop hate speech in all forms possible, not just at college campuses, but online and everywhere that hate speech can exist. If the courts will not side with us, then we will take justice into our own hands and bring peace everywhere we can. Praise Allah.